A recent study shows girls in Indiana lagging behind boys on science and math scores in high school. The gap doesn't exist in middle school, and as Josh and Lynn reports, researchers blame a variety of factors for the discrepancy.
Spacecraft, mission control, I have a message for the
It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and these sixth graders from Our Lady of Mount Carmel Catholic School in Indianapolis are being launched into space.
Mission control, this is spacecraft. I have a message for the entire crew. Over.
A recent study from St. Mary's College found girls at the age of these budding astronauts perform better than boys in math and science. But then something happens, and by ninth grade, they start to lag significantly behind their male peers. The study showed girls scoring as much as 39 points lower than boys on the math and science portions of the SAT. There were similar gaps on the ACT and AP exams.
In looking at education one of the things that we saw was, and this is not a new discovery, that there is a drop in interest, especially math and science, as girls transition from middle school to high school.
The million-dollar question is why. The St. Mary's study took a look at poverty, mental health, and violence as possible factors. Other studies have looked at MRIs, international testing data, infant attention spans, you name it. All of the research shows that there's not a single reason, but rather a lot of contributing factors. One reason that gets repeated a lot is the stereotype threat, a phenomenon first studied among black students in the early 1990s.
So in this case, if we've grown up, our mothers telling us or society telling us we're not as good at math as the boys are, we go into a room to take a math exam, and it is going to impact how we do.
At Perry Meridian High School on the southeast side of Indianapolis, the robotics team is preparing for next year's competition. Of 40 team members, 8 are girls. They attribute the drop in interest among their peers to a simple lack of awareness of math and science.
They think it's intimidating because they don't know, and they think, I would never be able to do that. I used to think that too.
They don't necessarily understand everything that we do, and once explained, it's like, oh, I should have joined that. I should have been involved as well.
Becky Combs is one of the team leaders. Like Stoll and Gilbert, she was also intimidated, but she suffered a knee injury and couldn't play on the basketball team that year. She joined the robotics team instead.
It's sometimes challenging, but a lot of the boys, I feel like, respect the girls. A lot of them actually come to me and ask me if they have a problem because I run the mill and I'm so diverse with the tools that I can explain things that they may not know how to do.
All three girls plan to continue down the science path as they enter college. They'll be part of Indiana's growing science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM, field. But national numbers show women only hold about a quarter of STEM jobs, according to the U.S. Census Bureau.
I think that men and women look at problems differently, and I believe, I think that the opportunities are equal, but I think the way people look at problems are different, and that's good. That gives you diversity of thought and good diversity on finding solutions.
Which brings us back to the girls in space, executing plans and problem solving to bring their team safely to the surface of the moon. Cindy Meyer, a longtime science educator, thinks emphasis on math and science needs to happen even earlier than middle school, going all the way back to elementary grades.
I also am wondering if we need to break this mold of one way to teach math and science. Maybe our girls need to learn math and science differently than some boys. Seeing them become more confident, seeing them be inspired, seeing the connection between this one-time job that they did in relationship to their education and what they're doing in the classroom. That's exciting.
I'm joined by Girls Inc. of Monroe County Executive Director Christy Mccann for more on this story. You know, we talked a lot about what we just saw about the scores, but the big difference between boys and girls. But there's also some more grim statistics in that St. Mary's study, referring to how girls struggle with depression, right, body image, weight gain, and even sexual violence. Right. Would you agree with that in that study?
Absolutely, I would agree with what their findings have been towards girls, yes.
And why is that?
I think a lot of it is how society's images have been portrayed on girls. And that's one of the things that Girls Incorporated strives for, is to give them an environment that they feel comfortable trying new things. And we really focus on those STEM topics and giving them those exposures, the science and engineering and mathematics for them.
Are there other key issues that girls are facing nowadays that we didn't cover here?
Well, a lot of the media influence, that is obviously affecting girls early on, all the way through high school. And I think that how we interpret the media, and we work at educating girls on how to handle the impressions from media that they are getting, and how society puts those pressures upon them, and we try to influence them in positive choices, and choices that sometimes girls aren't offered, such as the news article mentioned. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What are some of those maybe warning signs that parents, educators can pick up on from some of these girls who are having trouble, that they may need help?
Well, some of it might be just in their own self-image, and maybe their physical appearance, or they just are struggling with school. They are not wanting to partake in different activities. Those are some warning signs that parents should be aware of on if they just are not wanting to get participatory in mm-hmm. different things. And that's one of the things that we try to focus on with girls, is getting them into different activities that are a little different than maybe what they're offered in the school system, or that the parents may be offering them and talking with them at home. It's just a nice environment for the girls to have, to talk about what they want to talk about, and try different things hands-on. And that's important for girls, to be able to have those experiences outside of just the school system. So parents should be aware that there are a lot of different opportunities out there for their girls.
Okay, well, thank you very much for being here today. We appreciate your perspective on this very important topic.
Thank you.